Boom, 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 boom. What's up, peeps? Welcome back to another episode of Taz Kitchen. And today I'll be making a simple recipe, some buttermilk biscuits, okay? As you can see, I have all my ingredients right here, right? So first here, I got some unsalted butter. I don't know why I picked the wrong one, but it's a salted, but it's unsalted, okay? And I have some salt right here also that be going into my biscuit. And I have me some self-rising flour right here, as you can see. Yep, all right? And also, I have me a little bit of I'm gonna use some buttermilk. I could have made my own buttermilk, but I didn't at the time, so I just buy the one from the store. Okay, and I'll be using that one. And right here I have me some sugar. I'll be using like a tablespoon of sugar out of this. You can add maybe a tablespoon and a half or two to your preference, all right? But I'll be using a tablespoon of sugar right here. And that's it. That's five ingredients, you know, to make some buttermilk biscuit, all right? So just stick around, stay tuned, and watch me making this buttermilk biscuit. But here we do first. Watch the intro and come back. Okay, now peeps, into a bowl, going with 2 cups of flour, all-purpose flour. Okay, or self-rising flour, you can use either. I'm going in with a tablespoon of sugar, right? And that's 1 or 2 you can use. And now I'll be using a teaspoon of salt into that. And I'll go ahead and I have my sticker butter that was in the freezer, right? I'm going to grate that. I keep it in the freezer. You don't have to, but I prefer to keep it in the freezer because inside my house is a little bit warm and the butter is going to melt very fast. So I rather to keep it in the freezer and then grate it, okay? After I grate that, I'm going to go on in and I'm going to add that grated butter to my flour, salt, and sugar. All right, and you can see it sticking to the tray right here because it started to melt, as I told you before, okay? Now you're going to make like a breadcrumb consistency with your hands inside the flour. Incorporate everything, right? With that sugar, that salt, that butter, incorporate it well into the flour, because you need a breadcrumb consistency, all right? So just keep on flaking it out, okay? After that, you make a well inside that flour with your hands, and then I'm going in with 2 cups of buttermilk, all right? So going with 2 cups of buttermilk to the flour mixer, and we're going to go ahead, and then we're going to grab a fork, and I'm going to mix that around. I do not use my hands because it's going to get sticky, all right? So use a fork to mix it around, okay? When you see your flour is pulling away from your bowl, then you know the mixture is ready to go, all right? So once you see that, you know that, hey, you're in the green light, so ready to go, okay? All right, after that, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna flour my surface with some flour, generous amount of flour on that, because it's a very sticky dough, as I tell you before. You're gonna go ahead and you're gonna scrape all that out to your flour surface, all right? Get everything out on the surface. Yes, don't leave nothing at all in there. Scrape every last bit of it out there. All right? Yeah, man. Buttermilk biscuit. Oh, wow. Flaky, fluffy. Nice. Okay? After that, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to fold all that flour into my mixed dough. Get it incorporated, you know, and get this a little bit firmer. Okay? Now I'm going to go ahead and you're going to fold, you know, the flour over and pat it down to equal up the side. You want it to have like a square shape. All right, so as you can see, that's what I'm doing here, folding, flipping it and patting it to hold down, all right, because you need that. Then after that, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to do a four-fold. That's my first fold. Then you're going to press it down, flip it to the other direction, and you fold and press down, all right? And I did this 4 times. That's what I call a four-fold. And when you get that thickness that you want, then I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to cut my biscuit. I should be using a biscuit cutter, but I didn't have one, so I improvise, right? Yeah, you're a chef, so improvise. And I'm going to cut this biscuit out, and I dip my biscuit cutter back into the flour just for it not to be sticky, all right? And as you can see, cutting out the biscuits. And total right here, I received like about, 8 to 9 biscuit out of this recipe that I have here. Then you're going to go ahead and remove the excess flour, right, that you don't need. And that excess flour, you can use it to make more biscuit as you go along. So roll it up again and do the same thing. Repeat the process, make more biscuits out of that. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to add this to my skillet. All right. I did not have a flat bottom skillet, so I have to use this one that I had, and I put the biscuits in there. And as you can see, I'm putting the biscuits close together and to the edges of the skillet because I don't want it to spread apart, because they have a tendency to like spread right out, right? So I want the biscuit to hold. So that's why I'm using the skillet and holding them together. I could have used a baking tray, but it's not that much biscuit to put on it. So that is why I'm using my skillet, to keep the biscuit together, all right, and not spread right out. Bake those for 15 minutes at 475 degrees, all right? That's it, nothing more, nothing less. So 15 minutes, 475 degrees. As you can see right here, I'm going in with some butter over that, some melted butter over the biscuit right as you take it out the oven. And yes, people, that's it. Quick, simple, easy buttermilk biscuit. And when you press on the biscuit and it, you just see it bounce back at you, that means your biscuits are ready to go. Yeah. All right. I'm going to go ahead and plate this up. I did go ahead and make some chicken wings. All right. And as you can see, the biscuit is fluffy, flaky, and nice. Okay. Also, I did make some whiting, some deep fry whiting. All right. I'm going to go ahead and sprinkle a little bit of honey over my biscuit because I like it to be sweeter. And put a little pickled veggies over that. And that's it, people. Yep. Quick, simple, easy buttermilk biscuit. I believe in the recipes and description down below. All right, so don't worry.